Welcome to Eschmann Little Sister. Today, we're going to show you how to download cycle data from your SES 3000B and SES 2020N autoclave. Your autoclave stores data in its internal memory. To be compliant, you need to download these records to your computer on a weekly basis. The first step is to download the records from the autoclave's memory to a USB stick. You can then view the files with the Eschmann Cycle Logger software on your PC. If the software isn't already installed on your PC, you'll find the installation files on the USB stick supplied with your autoclave. If you no longer have the original USB stick, or you need help installing the software, contact our help desk. Here's a quick guide to installing the software. Depending how your computer is configured, a window may open up directly to display the contents of the USB stick, like this. Alternatively, in Windows 7, you may have to click Open Folder to view files in the pop-up which appears. Or, in Windows 10, you can simply click the Windows Explorer icon on your taskbar and then select the drive which corresponds to your USB stick. The software installation files are located in a folder labelled Cycle Logger Software Install. Double-click this folder to see its contents. There are six files in the folder. You want to run the setup file that is labelled as an application. Double-click the setup file to start the installation. If a Windows User Account Control window pops up, just click Yes to continue with the installation. Click Next three times and then Finish once the installation has completed. Now that the Cycle Logger software is installed on your PC, we can start to download data onto your USB stick. Insert your USB stick in the USB port behind your autoclave screen. Turn the autoclave on and wait for the home screen to appear. Tap the records icon in the lower right-hand corner of the screen and enter your PIN code. Use the up and down arrows to select all cycles and then tap OK. Select all since last download. Tap OK and the download will begin. If it's been a long time since the last download, you might want to do this at the end of the day because downloading several hundred cycles could take an hour or more. This is another good reason to make sure you download on a weekly basis. When the download is complete, tap OK and then the back arrow to reset the unit. You can now remove the USB stick and plug it into the USB port on your PC. Depending how your computer is configured, a window may open up directly to display the contents of the USB stick, like this. Alternatively, in Windows 7, you may have to click Open Folder to view files in the pop-up which appears. Or, in Windows 10, you can simply click the Windows Explorer icon on your taskbar and then select the drive which corresponds to your USB stick. Transferring the cycle records is as simple as copying and pasting the data to wherever you want to store it. But first, let's take a look at the contents of your USB stick. You'll see a folder called Eschmann. All your cycle data is in here. In addition, you may see a folder containing installation files for the Eschmann Cycle Logger software and PDFs of your autoclave's user manual in one or more languages. Let's look in the Eschmann folder. Within it, you'll see a folder called Autoclave. And within that, a folder that matches your autoclave's serial number. This is the folder you'll be copying to your PC. At the next level, you'll see one or more folders, each of which can contain up to 500 cycle records. The most recent records will be in the folder with the highest number range. Scroll to that folder and double-click to see its contents. Here are your individual cycle records, named by cycle number, the most recent record having the highest number. Don't be confused by the date shown in the Date Modified column. This date does not correspond to the date the cycles were run, only the date they were copied to the USB stick. Double-click one of these records and the Eschmann Cycle Logger software will launch and display the contents of the cycle log, showing the date, time, cycle type, temperature, pressure, and the result. Now, let's copy and paste the cycle data to your PC. First, close the log file and the Cycle Logger software and use the back arrow to return to the level where the serial number folder is displayed in the window. You can choose to store your cycle data anywhere on your PC or network, but we strongly recommend you choose a location that gets backed up regularly so that your data can be easily restored in the event of an IT glitch or a problem with your PC. For example, you could save the data on a network drive or to a folder that synchronizes with a cloud storage service like Dropbox, Google Drive, Microsoft OneDrive, or others. But some practices will choose to keep it simple by saving the files to a folder on the desktop, which is what we're going to do here. But bear in mind that files and folders on your desktop may not be accessible to other users and may not be backed up. Let's create a folder on the desktop called Eschmann Autoclave Logs. Right-click in an empty space on the desktop, choose New, and then Folder, and then type in the name you want for the folder. Now back to the contents of your USB stick. Right-click on the serial number folder and choose Copy. Now position your mouse over your destination folder. Right-click and choose Paste. When all the files have been copied, you will have a complete set of records in your chosen folder and also still on your USB stick and your autoclave. Once you've copied the files, you should check that your cycle logs are all present and correct. In the folder where you saved the cycle data on your PC, navigate through the serial number folder and the folder with the highest number range to the cycle log with the highest number. Open the file and check that the date and time are correct. One final tip. Before you remove the USB stick from the PC, make sure it's safe to remove. You can do this by right-clicking on its drive letter in Windows Explorer and choosing Eject, or clicking the Remove Hardware icon in the bottom right of your taskbar and then selecting the appropriate device. Doing this reduces the risk of data corruption. And that's it. We hope this guide has been useful. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more guides and tips, and contact us if you need further help or advice.